Hello guys, welcome back to our YouTube channel Learn with Geeks. From the past few days, people were continuously giving me suggestions to include SQL interview videos also. As for the Power BI developer position, many companies are asking questions on SQL also along with Power BI. Even I had the plan to upload the videos on SQL but at a later stage since I was focusing only on the Power BI questions right now. But as people are suggesting to upload the videos on SQL also, so today I have come up with a video on SQL. Basically the SQL questions that are being frequently asked along with Power BI. So let's start the video without wasting any time. As per my experience, I would recommend you all to have a moderate level knowledge on SQL also, as in most of the companies, interviewers are asking questions on SQL for Power BI position. In this video, I have focused only on the theoretical concepts of SQL. So please watch till the end, it will be very helpful for you. So let's start with the first question. What is the difference between a primary key and a unique key? This is a very common question asked in most of the interviews for Power BI developer position. You can pause and think of the solution. Okay, let's have the solution. So primary key is a column or a set of columns whose value exists and is unique for every record in the table, and it can't contain null values, and we can have only one primary key in a table. Okay, in this way you have to answer about the primary key. If I talk about unique key, it is similar to primary key but it can contain null values and we can have more than one unique key in a table. So this is the basic difference between a primary key and a unique key. Okay, so let's move to the next question. What is a candidate key? Think of the solution. Let's have the solution. So these are the set of attributes which can uniquely identify any two tuples in the table. And among this set of attributes, we choose one attribute as our primary key and rest of the attributes are alternate keys. So in this way, you have to answer about this candidate key. So if you are not knowing it prior, so now you know the answer of this question. Let's move to the next question. What is a constraint? Think of the answer. Let's have the solution. So these are the specific rules or limits that we define in our table. For example, not null, auto increment, and many others like primary key also, foreign key also. So these all are constraints. So in this way, you have to answer this question. Let's move ahead with the next question. Can you differentiate between truncate and delete? Okay. So let's have the solution now. So if you talk about truncate, so whenever we are truncating, the auto increment values will be reset. So since in the last question I talked about the constraint like auto increment, so for if any column has the auto increment constraint, so the values of that column will be reset if we are doing the truncation, and it delivers the output much quicker than the delete as it does not remove the values row by row. Okay. And if I talk about delete, so it removes the record row by row and the auto increment values are not reset with delete and it is slower than truncate. So in this way you can differentiate between truncate and delete. Let's move ahead with the next question. What is the major difference between union and union all? Think of the answer. Let's have the solution. So union displays only the distinct values in the output and uses more computational power and storage space. But if I talk about union also, it retrieves the duplicates also in the output and uses less computational power and storage space as compared to the union. So in this way, you can differentiate between union and union all. Okay, so let's move ahead with the next question. When do we use having clause? Also tell, do we write it after or before of group by? Okay, so let's have the solution. So we use having clause whenever we are doing some kind of aggregations like sum, min, count, etc. And we have to include a condition with it. So in that case, we use having clause. And we will be using the having clause after group by, not before. Okay. So let's move ahead with the next question. What is the difference between a view and a stored procedure? Okay. Let's have the solution. View is the virtual table whose contents are obtained from an existing table, or you can see the base tables, and it is basically a select statement. Okay. And if you talk about stored procedure, so An SQL statement or a set of SQL statements that can be stored on the database server are the stored procedures. So in this way, you can differentiate between a view and a stored procedure. Let's move ahead with the next question. What is the difference between a CTE, that is common table expression, and a temporary table? Let's have the solution. CTE can be thought as a temporary result set that is defined within the execution scope of a single select, insert, update, delete, or create view statement. And if I talk about temporary tables, so these are stored in temporary database and gets deleted as soon as the session is terminated. So temporary tables basically depend on the session in which we have logged in. Let's move ahead with the next question. Differentiate between a clustered index and a non-clustered index. Okay, let's see the solution. So clustered index determines the physical order of the data in a table, and the table can have only one clustered index. So basically, whenever we create a primary key for our table, the clustered index is automatically generated for that column. Okay, now if I talk about non-clustered index, so it is analogous to an index in a textbook. The data is stored in one place and the index in other place. The index will have the pointers to the storage location of the data. A table can have more than one clustered index. Okay, so in this way you can differentiate between clustered and non-clustered index. Let's move ahead with the next question. Explain triggers. This is the last question of this video. So let's have the solution now. So triggers are the SQL codes that are automatically executed in response to certain events on a particular table, and these are mainly used to maintain the integrity of data. So in this way you can answer what are triggers. Thank you for watching the video. I hope you have learned a lot through this video and got some idea about the SQL questions asked in Power BI interviews. Next video will be on SQL queries that are being frequently asked. So stay tuned. Please hit the like and subscribe button as it will give me the motivation to upload more videos for you all. Thank you.